this old town is filled with things. It'll swallow you in if you got some money to burn. Take it home right away, 'cause you got 3 years to pay. Oh, and Satan is waiting his turn. This old earthquake's gonna be in the boardwalk. Feels like this whole town's inside. On the 31st floor, a gold-plated door won't keep out the Lord.
It'll all wash away if we don't believe anymore. One time, I'll recruit, and our rainbow hair suit, so please show you I need and don't. It seems like this whole town's insane. On the 31st floor, a gold-plated door won't keep out the Lord of the Rings.
Should be the template for any musical hall of fame anywhere. The amount of reverence that they show toward the foundational creators of the genre and all those that have come after. So it's an honor to be a part of this exhibit that has to do with that next stage of the Tom Joad road that led to California's version of country music, California country rock, California country music. You know, yeah. Chris Hillman is
from not to
the king of country rock.
But that bar here, the Troubadour, and folks that are watching this probably don't see, but more music came out of that through that door into this room. Joni Mitchell and Elton John, the Birds played here one night when we started out. Flying Reader Brothers played here, but you know, it was Dwight. It was so interconnected and such as you put well put. For many years, the edge of the continent, yeah. The Tom Joad Road, and everybody comes out, be they musicians or actors or writers or artists, and they stop there at the Pacific Ocean, and that's it.
All you have to do it or swim.
Wildly creative people, and that's where you had this wonderful period of time that we celebrate through the Country Music Hall of Fame. Country rock, California country music.
So thanks to the Hall of Fame.
That's right, thank you to the Hall of Fame.
Thank you guys for creating this and showcasing this particular chapter of California country music. It's so well deserved, and Chris is getting his due, rightfully so, and in this exhibit, and all those that were a party to it, from Mike Nesmith to Linda Ronstadt and beyond, all of it, Emmy Lou. The great Emmy Lou, those records with Brian Hearn. Like I said, there was a mythology about those guys with long hair when I saw Chris and the burritos in those suits that drew me to the West Coast. It was one of the things in those records that sometimes I sing incorrect lyrics or sometimes adjusted melodies, because Emmy would adjust things into thirds at times, right? She could sing a tenor part now and then.
Yes, she can.
When she was,
bless her. And,
but
you know,
and I'm prone as a hillbilly kid to do that myself. So thank you for allowing me to perform this with you today, and in honor of kicking off the press.
My honor, and we have so many. I mean, Rose Maddox and the Maddox Brothers, and they all have that. They're on that Tom Joad Road. The Maddox Brothers have had your family and the Owens family, and as you well know, but you can always. We're telling you all this because it's very important. The Bakersfield Beat,
yeah.
On Sirius XM, Dwight Yoakam's Bakersfield Beat, he gets right into the cusp of it all, the history of it all, and I love it.
When they conceived this, like I said, a couple of years ago, they started talking about it, right? They came to you and they reached out to me.
Yeah,
we're about to do this next chapter. I said, it's you know, long overdue, and it's so great that finally, because everybody's dealt with the first incarnation of the sound, you know, whether it's, you know, from the Depression up through Buck and Merle. But not many have dealt with, you know, the things that came after, the things that inspired me, like I said, as a you know, teenager and then in college, and it drew me to the West Coast. It was the Beacon, that stuff. You know, Wheels, Sin City, those were two I could do. You know, Linda's version of Wheels, you know. Mm-hmm. Anyway.
Can I tell you something? The other day on your radio show, you played the coolest song ever. It's not
personally me. I did.
Well,
may I personally?
It was Peggy Lee. That's all there is.
Lieber
Stoller wrote that. And I'm going, okay, that's in the middle of Bakersfield Beat. This
great,
song was
it's
so
greater
good.
Bakersfield, the point of that and what
the
country is doing, mm-hmm. is continuing that kind of exposition of how far the music reached. I mean, when you're talking about this generation, what Chris kicked off with that time between led to everything that Jackson Browne did after, everything Linda did, you know, all of that. I think they would all honestly credit, you know, what Chris did in the Birds and around the Birds and then after, you know, with Graham when they formed the Burritos. So it's and Peggy Lee, Chris, the reason I do it, you know, I didn't explain to you why. It's all part and parcel of that Wrecking Crew moment, you know, all that great music that was made out here, you know. And the country, you know, the first two Monkees albums had country rock in it because that Texan Mike Nesmith, you know, was allowed to be let loose with his own songwriting, you know. I mean, the first hit Linda ever had was a Mike Nesmith song, Different Drums. So
that's right.
All of that is covered in the Western Edge. I mean, they're doing almost Ken Burns level kind of research and referencing it. It was fascinating to do my interview portion with them, because I'd say, are you dealing with, you doing this or that, and yeah, we've got that. We've got things beyond what I even, you know, was aware of. So, and even Steven Stills in that cowboy hat he had, Chris, when he was doing the duck walk when Neil started playing Soul Man. I forget what TV show you said you got in the clip where he was doing, for what it's worth, right, the Sunset Strip rides, but then they went into Soul Man. So you see, Steven, I said I was a kid again. That kind of jet age cowboyness that was going on in the Sunset Strip, late 60s, early 70s, I owe a great debt of gratitude.
You know? Ever hear Guitar Slim, great song, The Things That I Used to Do? I think Stephen plays that every night. Anyway, so we're moving right along from Dwight. Go ahead.
No, I talk more than I'm allowed.
No.
But we're not supposed to take your time. Thank you guys for coming and for helping the Hall of Fame come to LA, and I think what an appropriate setting, you know, to kick off the Western Edge. It changed everything.
Yeah, thank you, everybody. Thanks so much.